Assalamu alaikum, what's up guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in this video we are going to see how we can handle the back press event in Flutter. Okay, so in this project here I have a stateless widget with class of my app, and in the home of material app I am returning a first page, and this is also a stateless widget. Here I have created another dart file, screens.dart, and here I have two stateless widgets, one for first page and second page. The content is almost same. In the first page I have in center elevated button, and in which I am navigating to this second page, and in the second page I have a text in the center. Okay, so let's run this project first and then we'll continue on with how we can handle the back press event. Okay, so after running the code, when I click this button, it navigates to screen 2, and when clicking back, it just pops out. Okay, so what if I want to override the back press ability? Let's say when I navigate to screen 2 and when I click this devices back button, it does the same. So what if I want to override this feature? So in Flutter we have will pop scope widget for that. So let's see how we can implement. So before the center, I will wrap this it with will pop scope, which has a property, which has a required property of on will pop, which returns a function. And in the on will pop, let's say we first try to print something. And now when I click this button, it will print something. So what if I want to navigate to screen 2 by clicking this back button? By reloading, let's test it. When I click this button, it has routed to screen 2. You guys might have seen in a lot of applications that by clicking this button you might have received a pop-up asking you to log out from your profile, or if you need to exit from application or not, and so on. Examples, there are a lot of examples you can do with this event. Let's say I want to disable. So since will pop scope returns a future with a bool, and when we talk about future, we have to use the async and await. So async and just return a false, since it requires future with bool. So right now when I click this button, it has just disabled this ability. So it will do nothing. And let's say I want to show a dialog when user clicks this button. So for that I am creating a function show dialog, which has a context, Okay, so in the will pop scopes on will pop, after this async, I will return this show dialog function. Let's hot restart. Okay, so when I click this button, it has shown me the dialog test with content, are you sure, blah blah blah. And yes, it is working fine. So that's all from this video, guys. I hope you like it, and if you did, please share this video with your friends, and do not forget to subscribe to this channel. And for more videos, stay tuned and hit the bell icon. And thank you so much, guys, for watching this video, and thank you so much for supporting me. Take good care of yourselves. Allah Hafiz.